When the world was young and all creatures were new, the first moth came out of his cocoon. When he opened his eyes, the first thing he saw was the moon. Filled with love, he stretched out his small wings for the first time to try and fly.
And so the moth began his journey.
How can
first,
I reach
to the valley of savage.
I am too small.
Moth, I am the spirit of river. I have heard your plea. As you are a creature of the air, I would gladly help you. But my brothers, the spirits of earth, water, and fire, would surely disapprove. If you can get their blessing, I will take you.
Thank you, air. Where may I find them?
To the north you will find brutal earth. Fickle water resides to the west. To the south is fire. Be wary of fire, little moth, for he is untrustworthy.
And so the moth began his journey, first to the valley of savage earth.
I am the earth spirit. Who dares enter my domain?
Noble earth, I am moth. I wish to go to the moon, for I love her.
Aha! Stay grounded, and stop dreaming of the moon. You should go home and be a simple moth. I should teach you a lesson. Moth, you have my blessing. Just...
But I am so weak. Well, I guess you can keep strength. I think I'll stick to flying.
Moth then made his way to the lake of capricious water.
Behold, I am the spirit of water. Why does such a dry insect come to my domain?
Kindly, water, I am moth. I wish to go to the moon, for I love her.
A moth in love with the moon? That sounds fishy. You should abandon this quest and go find an adventure more suited to one such as me. Perhaps I should see how you fly under the water.
Merciful water, wait. Before you drown me, I've always want to see your true power. Being a creature of the air, I've only heard of your majesty.
Go on.
Well, I have heard that you can fill any space, that you can be as big as the ocean itself.
Naturally!
Oh my, that is impressive. But big is not that difficult. Earth is big, and he is quite foolish. I bet you can't be as small as, say, flower.
The audacity! I can fill any space. Let me out, you beastly creature! I will give you permission to spit me out!
Please!
Go to the moon! Go anywhere! Just go!
Finally, off went south to the domain of consuming fire.
You are the little moth who wishes to travel to the moon.
Yes, for I love her.
Are you stupid? You are a moth, and she is the moon. What could she ever see in something like you? I will devour you.
Thank you.
You can barely move now.
I don't need to. Naive insect.
Leave us, Air, and thank you for telling me about fire's cruelty. Little Moth, you have come such a long way from home, all to reach me. But why?
You are the moon, and I love you with all my heart.
Never has any creature gone so far as you have, and all for the love of me. From my place in the sky, I have never found anything that so adored me as you. From this day forward, you will be my champion, forever bearing the mark of my favor upon your wings. But you are a creature of the air and must return to your home. Likewise must I return to my place of loneliness in the sky. But know that as I shine, I will forever be looking out to you, O worthy Moth. You will always have a place in my heart.
And so the moon returned to the sky, and the moth returned home. For creatures as different as they cannot live together in our world. However, even today the moth will come out at night to dance in the moonlight. For although they cannot be together, a piece of each will always reside in the other's heart.